My day job, I spent 20 odd years making science documentaries, mostly for BBC, BBC4. The last 8 years I've been writing about finance. The reason I'm running for leader is because I think this party desperately needs to have a serious conversation about what it thinks about finance and economics. It seems to me one of the defining facts of our times is around the world and in this country, the main political parties have all surrendered to the idea that finance and economics no longer needs to be what it should be under democratic control. It needs to be left to the technocrats. There needs to be a party which says it's dangerous and it's utterly undemocratic. I would like to be a party. This party needs to say clearly and cogently and passionately to the electorate that unless we bring back under democratic control our tax corporations and our currency, all back under democratic control, we're able to deliver on all the wonderful things that are in our manifesto. Because we, the economy, the finance, and the international laws that surround it, you will, even if we get into power, be told, oh no, sorry, you can't do it. First and foremost, we need to stop CETA, TTIP, and a host of other things with bilateral investment treaties. Unless we know about it and tell the electorate these things need to be dealt with, then our manifesto is a nice fairy story. It won't happen for international law reasons. But we can do something about it. I think the other reason we need to say this to the electorate is when I campaign on the doorstep, what people say is, I know you're a lovely party full of lovely people, but really, you just think all problems can be solved by hugging a tree and kissing away. They want to know, do we know how to run the rest of a country? We do, but they don't know that. And in the election, we didn't speak very much about economics and finance, and when we did, it wasn't terribly effective. That has to be changed. Otherwise, the electorate will continue to see us as a really well-intentioned protest group. And I don't want to be a member of a protest group, I want to be a member of an effective political party. And to do that, you have to be able to say, we understand economics and finance and international law, and we understand how these things can be changed for the better. I think that this country is crying out because a hole opening up. People are tired of stifling conformity, but both of the major political parties essentially agree on all of their assumptions. And so when they talk about opposition, it's like opposition between Chelsea and Man United. Someone will win, but the outcome is utterly irrelevant. They're all playing the same game. We need to say those starting assumptions are wrong, and here are better ones, well worked out, cogently argued. As a leader, I think you need to be able to listen to the party at large, but you also need to be able to go on Question Time, or you need to go on Newsnight, and be able to stand toe to toe with them, and disagree with their starting assumptions. If you accept their assumptions, if you allow them to dictate the terms of the debate, you will lose. You will end up apologising. We have to say, the place where you started from is wrong. That's what I would like to do. Thank you.